Alright, you probably guessed it already from the title and stuff. This is a paper Sean. And you probably have already seen and guessed that this is a chemistry video. Now, I promised that I would create science videos on the Big Fat Notebooks, and I haven't even completed it, but this is a separate series. I'm using Cognito's chemistry series, the video series, and as one of my sources for all of this information, and the complete high school guide to everything you need to ace chemistry in one Big Fat Notebook. Also, I am not going to go in this order. I'll make a separate series on this book. But for now, let's just talk about chemistry. Today, with atoms and ions, the building blocks. All right, so the first question that comes into mind when we talk about atoms is basically, what do they look like? Unlike the app I'll be using to show you molecules and compounds, they actually represent atoms with little balls. Now, this is a good way to actually talk and represent atoms, but it is very inaccurate. Although there are a lot of other types of models, like the space filling model, which basically just makes it look bigger in this case. And yes, there is such a thing as the sticks model. Wait, did I say sticks? Yeah, sticks model, which only works when you like combine them together, and that just gets you into a stick. That gives you a stick with a molecule on the other side. But we'll talk about molecules in more depth in the next episode. And for our purposes, whenever we're using this app, we will be using the ball and stick model. So, let's get to it. Now, we will not be using the balls other than the ones in the app to ask models for an atom while we're using it on the paper. Instead, we will be using these. This model. With like the lines representing the orbitals of the electrons. Now this is a very inaccurate version of a model of an atom. It's useful, right? But it's very inaccurate. In fact, nowadays we actually found out that the electrons around the atom, so I'll get into each part of these later, do not orbit around the nucleus like this, but actually they like spin around in like a cloud of probabilities. So the electron could be here, or 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 here, zipping around at random places at the random times. Now let's color code this. Now I just randomly draw an atom, so I will have to add more here. So like, let's just put in 5 more balls. I'll explain why I put in just 5 more balls. And not like 6 or 7. Also, it is possible to actually add 6 more balls. Now, in this visual representation, yellow are electrons. Blue are neutrons. And green are protons. I'm doing it this way because this is an easy way for me to remember it, and I'll show later why I chose these. Actually, right now, in fact, this is a carbon atom. And, an atom is made from these 3 parts. Protons and neutrons are always clumped together into a little ball into the nucleus. It has to be inside the middle. It's like the middle of an atom. And electrons orbit around the nucleus. We're only using this visual because this is the easiest and the most used version. Well, actually, the clouds of probability are the most actual, is the most accurate representation. It's just like very hard to understand and very hard to know where the electrons are, which is not useful in our case. So let's get started on the rest. Oh, great. Now that that's about done, let me tell you more about these 2 particles. Protons and neutrons have the same mass. So they're said to have a mass of 1. However, protons actually, however, electrons really are way smaller than the protons and neutrons, and so there are a lot of variations. It can be a little decimal, but mainly it can even be said to have a mass of zero, so this is very inaccurate, but we'll just be using that representation for now. And however, their electrical charges are all different. Protons have a positive charge, neutrons have a neutral charge, as you probably have guessed, and electrons have a negative charge. Huh, pretty easy to remember, right? Pro for positive, neutra for neutral, and electron, well, you'll just have to memorize that, but I like to think of it as positive protons, neutral neutrons, and then there's only negative left and the electrons left, so they have, so the electrons has to be negative. All right, now that that's done, let me tell you more about these later. You may have, actually right now, you may have learned, you may have noticed that the protons number is the same number as the electrons. Why is that? So that they cancel out each other. I mean, it doesn't always have to be necessarily the same number of electrons and protons. But if it wasn't the same number of protons or the same number of electrons, if their numbers weren't equal, then they'd be not even called an atom. That thing, that atom, wouldn't even be called an atom anymore. It would have been called an ion. Now let me show you an ion, a version of carbon. Actually, it's not, is it inaccurate to actually call it a version, because it's still carbon, just in a different form. All right, let me just quickly draw another carbon atom. Boop. And now, before I continue to actually shading it, I would like to note that an electron, and that this is not the actual scale. This drawing is not actual drawn scale. If an atom was a baseball stadium, I don't know, actually, let's call it the soccer field, really, because that's easier, and I was taught to that, and these are all the places where the people are sitting. And if the nucleus was just a little pin pick in the middle of the stadium, then the electron would be like somewhere on the outskirts of the places where the people watch, and they're actually way smaller than the dots I've just drawn. They'd be like tiny, even at this size. You have to zoom in just very far. And that's about it. That's just the scale introduction. And now, color coded now. Let's say there were more electrons than protons in this carbon atom. Actually, let's not use in this atom, actually. Let's not call it carbon, because it's not carbon anymore, because there's one less of a proton. The number of protons determines what type of atom it is, and now that it's one less of a proton, it cannot be a proton. I'll explain in the next video. And sorry for all those gentlemen who really want an explanation right now. Then there will be way much more to do it. So now that there are 5 protons, but there are 6 electrons, only 5 of these, both of them, cancel out. And so there's only one negative out there. So this has, and so this is called a negative ion. But however, if it's only just one more just electron, then it's a 1 minus negative ion. If we just added like 2 more protons, then, well, it wouldn't even be called a negative ion. Instead, it will have just one more positive one, and then it will be turned into a positive ion. And same goes for all the other ones. And that is the basics of atoms and ions. And that is all for today's episode. So I hope you guys enjoyed this episode. And if you guys did enjoy this episode, please like, share, and subscribe to this channel if you haven't already. And I'll see you guys in the next episode. Shnan out. Peace.